How's everybody doing today? Give yourself a hand. Give yourself a hand, man. Listen, this is 1247, the great one, man. This is 1247, the great one. How's everybody doing today? How's everybody doing on today? Hopefully everybody's doing good, man. We're gonna get into it today. This game, you can see under my name, it says no accountability equals no community. Uh-oh. No accountability equals no community. What says no accountability, no community? But man, but before we get into that, let me play this song by the Dramatics. You may know it. It's called What You See Is What You Get. Let's play this real quick. Ready?
Then what you see is what you get. Ha! What you see is what you get.
Is what you get.
What you get.
It's what you get.
It's the best thing yet. The best thing yet.
Chuck. Give them brothers a hand. What you see is what you get. No accountability. Without accountability, there is no community. Gentlemen, accountability within the so-called American Black community really doesn't exist. But the question I gotta ask you, gentlemen, do you honestly have a community if there's no accountability? Hold up. Let's rewind that. Do you gentlemen necessarily have a community if there's no accountability? How is everything in this so-called American Black community? How is everything just everything? How does the buck get passed on to everybody? Now, how does things that are going on in your so-called community, how do things get swept under the rug? How do things get swept under the rug? I know the all type of debauchery is going on around us, but it's really not so-and-so's fault. It's really not her, his fault. You know, I gotta talk about your boy Umar Johnson. Gotta throw him in there. Because it just seems like accountability is just, once again, the finger gets a point in one direction, but the people, the finger, like this, men are getting blamed for something that women and children are doing. But if you men didn't put these women in this certain position in the first place, it wouldn't be happening. Does that make any sense? All type of crime, robbery, all types of stuff going on around us that's been going on for the last at least 50 some odd years. Can we say, hey, listen, if you men would have worked harder, if you men would have did this, if you men would have done X, Y, and Z, then these women wouldn't do this? Like, does that sound like logical? Does that sound like sense to you? Seriously, does that sound like sense to you? Here, let's hear a soundbite real quick. My bad.
Definitely no better.
Shout out to sister. Sorry. Shout out. Thank you. Fair use, by the way. Just going to play a little bit of sound. Listen to this, gentlemen. This is your boy. My bad. I just skipped a little.
You see that? So when a black woman says, I don't need a man, that is a reaction to the reality that I may not get a man.
So why not preach? Because I understood, you know, you're obviously against interracial relations when it comes to black men with black women. I mean, with white women.
With all women. You should only be with the black woman.
And you will say, well, if you can't find a good woman.
What the? So this is your man. So your man Umar Johnson is against all interracial relationships. So once again, isn't that what we say? Isn't that penis policing? That's penis policing, right? Because you know you can't be with the women that you want. You should only be with a black woman. Black woman, where, my friend? So if I go to Brazil, can I go to Brazil and do that? Can I go to Colombia and do that? But hold up, but first of all, who's giving Dr. Umar Johnson the authority to say who you can and cannot be with? Who has given him, seriously, gentlemen? Let's rewind that. Are you, gentlemen, giving Dr. Umar Johnson the authority to quote unquote penis police you? Dr. Umar Johnson can sit there and say to you who you can and cannot be with. You gentlemen, can't be passport bros. You brothers can't be SYSBM. You can't save yourself. You brothers can't be MGTOW. You have to sit here. You have to be in this community. You can't go out there and be a man like you're supposed to be. Create your own community, but you have to be here amongst these people. That's not doing the same thing you're doing, but you gotta be here because you got the same human flesh. Come on, gentlemen. You just laugh and stop. Let's keep going. Fair use.
America, there's somewhere else.
Absolutely.
So why not teach that same rhetoric to our women? Like,
I tell sisters all the time, go to Africa. So I know sisters who marry. I just spoke with a sister. She invited me to the wedding. She just married a brother from the continent.
So, but instead of saying they will never get married,
I'll take sisters to Africa who married brothers they met in Africa.
Right.
So yeah, I think
I think there's obviously plenty of black men.
Yes,
and black
it is.
Women.
So and what I also tell black women, if you're going to go get you an African man from the continent,
right,
you're going to have to understand that the way in which you talk to black men in America mm-hmm. will not be tolerated over there.
Mm-hmm. Why the fuck is it tolerated? It's not tolerated here. That's what we're trying to tell them.
Well,
see, this was shout out to the Daily Rabbit crew, man. Give them brothers a hand, man. Give them brothers. Give them three young brothers a hand. So once again, see, this is what I'm saying, gentlemen. In your community, you are the one that's bound to this community. You have to be the titan. You have to bury. You have to bear everything. Whatever choices she's make, you have to sit there and bear. But once again, she can go free. She can go to Africa and marry all these men. She can go over here and marry all these men. But no, you can't. No. Gentlemen, she can go to Africa. It's fine. She can go freely and go to Africa. But no, gentlemen, if you quote unquote date outside your race, you can't do that. See, that's what I'm saying, gentlemen. It's a double standard. Your so-called community here in the United States is double standard. Everything is double standard when it comes to you, gentlemen. You, once again, the gun gets held to your head. You got to sit here and you got to do this and you. But when it comes to your so-called your rib, now they can go off and do whatever they want to do because this is what's happening right now. Let's keep going.
So over here, I want to say this to us, though. Mm. Because we try to act like the way sisters treat us doesn't have a history that we are not at least partly responsible for. Let's be honest. The black woman has had to hold down the black house by herself, although imperfectly, mm-hmm. She's had to do it by herself since the mass incarceration of black males began in the 1970s. You understand me? Mm-hmm. Most of our children are raised by a single mother right now. Mm-hmm. And it has been that way for about 50 years. So when his sister says, I don't need a man, because she couldn't find one strong enough to hold her down.
See, and this is when people laugh at you, gentlemen. This is why people laugh at you, gentlemen, in the community. Because you got this guy right here saying that, hey, listen, these women had to hold it down by themselves. See, gentlemen, we've heard the narrative so many times. We heard the narrative so many times. So many times. So the mass incarceration of black men back in the 70s caused these women to be by themselves for all these years. Okay, but once again, nobody wants to talk about 1967. I did a video last year, 2 years ago. Cushing versus Virginia. Tell me, go look this up. Before the 70s even hit, 1967, quote unquote, American black women and a so-called white man go to Supreme Court. They took a case that was in Backwoods, Virginia somewhere. They went all the way up to the Supreme Court. Once again, sister walked hand in hand with a so-called white man for her to have laws changed so they could be interracial relationships. It was a so-called black woman that did this. You guys can look this up. Cushing versus Virginia. Go look this up, 1967. Once again, it wasn't a so-called black man in a snow bunny that went up to the Supreme Court hand in hand. Because that would happen, a so-called black man would have went up there hand in hand with a quote-unquote snow bunny. He'd have been assassinated. But once again, we don't want to take accountability. Now, once again, gentlemen, yeah, we can say, you know, we have part to play in that. Let's, you know, I can't 100% point the finger at these women and say, oh, well, this, yeah, John, we did. I see where he's coming from. So, yeah, we did kind of have a part to play in that. But once again, if these women chose in 1967, you guys basically gave the thumbs up to that woman to go to Supreme Court because nobody protested against it. There was no large outcry of a so-called a lot of these sisters protesting that decision that woman made with that so-called white man in 1967. There wasn't. In 1968, what happened? Civil rights. Then what happened? You know, these women, they dipped off. So you chose in 67, you chose your partner. In 68, you rolled out. So once again, we got to take accountability for that. There hasn't been any type of accountability for 1967, 1968. There hasn't been any type of apology. There hasn't been anything. It's like 1967, Cushing versus Virginia never happened in the so-called community. There hasn't been accountability for that decision 50 plus years ago, damn near 56 years ago. In 68, hey, here comes Margaret Sanger and all them. So 67, you chose. 68, you rolled out. Here comes the government, Margaret Sanger. Here comes the feminist movement behind that. Then after that, here comes the 70, the mass incarceration. So once again, it wasn't just mass incarceration. Oh, these sisters were by themselves. No, man, listen, man, stop telling these f-ing lies. See, this is why I can't stand about men like Brother Johnson right here, man. Tell the truth. But once again, accountability goes right out the window. Can Brother Umar Johnson, can you at least say it in 1967? Listen, these women gave Miss Cushing, they gave her the thumbs up to go to Supreme Court in 1967, hand in hand with the so-called white man, to have laws changed. To have laws changed so so-called black people and white people can now be together. Come on, man. Let's be honest about what's going on right now. There has to be honesty. If there is no accountability, there's no honesty, gentlemen. You don't have a f***ing community. If there's no accountability, your community is done. It's a wrap. We want to talk about mass incarceration in the 70s. But once again, we skip right over 1967, Cushing versus Virginia. We skip right over that. 1968, hey, civil rights. These women rolled out. It is what it is. I can't, you know, I'm not mad. It is what it is. But there's no talk about that because that's accountability. But once again, all these sisters had to hold it down by themselves. There's, you know, when these sisters said they don't need no man, there's some history behind it because mass incarceration, there was no man. Like he just said, there was no man out there for these women to marry because everybody was locked up. Gentlemen, see, this is why, once again, this is why you hear laughter.
What?
My bad. This is why you hear laughter. Every time you fellas walk outside and you think you're doing something, people behind closed doors, this is what they're doing. And I told you, gentlemen, it's not on a woman. The women have already chose, gentlemen, for the past 50-some-odd years, ever since 1967. These women have chose their partner. They chose. I'm not, once again, gentlemen, I'm not mad. But see, the thing is, this is one thing about the so-called American Black community. Everything that's, a lot of the history that's being said, well, not even history, a lot of the things that are talked about, it always goes back. See, that's, man. See, a lot of things that's happening today, he's right. It has been a buildup over the last 50 some odd years. I'm not even going back to slavery. I'm not including that, those times, because I don't want to hear about no traumatic slave disorder. That's stupid. I don't want to hear about no post-traumatic slave disorder. No, nobody even knows what slavery even looks like. Let's be honest. Nobody. So you can say, oh, that trauma was passed down, bloodline after bloodline and all that stuff. Gentlemen, man, listen, that sounds dumb as shit. Nobody's talking about so-and-so robbing and stealing because of post-traumatic slave disorder. Little Ray Ray and Pookie out there robbing each other because a post-traumatic slave disorder. Little Bobby shot Johnny down the street because they were playing a dice game because of post-traumatic slave disorder. Tamika out there on the car, butt naked twerking in the middle of the street because of post-traumatic slave disorder. See, gentlemen, this is why everybody, once again, is just, it's just laughing at you. You gentlemen are the court jesters of the world. You brothers still sitting around in this community. You're the court jesters. You're the joker of the world. You're just a joke, my friend. You're just a joke. There's no accountability that's being taken, because accountability hasn't been taken in the last 50 some odd years. But the finger's been pointed at you for how long? All this time, the finger has always been pointed at you, so-called men in the community. It's always been pointed at you. You didn't do this. You didn't build. You. But on the other hand, you the one, you the one that rolled out. Your grandmama rolled out, your great-grandma, all them women rolled out. And still to this day, you women are still hand in hand with your government. You still have been integrated into a burning building, like I just did my last video. these women have been integrated with the American government. So, gentlemen, what community do you have? What community do you have, gentlemen? No accountability. Accountability is like a curse word to Black American people. It's like a curse word. Accountability is a curse word. Once again, the fact that is, there's failures in our face, gentlemen. There's failures going on all around us in our so-called community. There's failures going on all over the place. Like I said in one of my shows on another platform, listen, with failure comes recognition, and with recognition comes growth. I'm gonna say it again, with every failure that's in the community should come recognition. With that recognition comes growth. Once again, how are you gentlemen in a community that doesn't first of all recognize its failures? And the thing is, it ignores its failures. And they tell you, no, these failures aren't really happening. And this is why everybody around you is. So all these failures going around in your community, we see it every single day, John. We can turn on the TV, we see failures after failures after failure after failure. Yes, there's some good things going on, but gentlemen, there's a lot of failures going on in your community. But there's lack of accountability. So tell me, if there's lack of accountability, gentlemen, you really don't have a community. This community does not belong to you. If this is what you gentlemen doing, you after all these years, think about it, gentlemen. Because your father and them wasn't talking about accountability with these females. Your granddaddy, sure enough, wasn't talking about being accountable with these females. Your great-grandfather probably wasn't talking about being accountable with these females. But once again, 2023, we are trying to do something. We are trying to undo something. How can I say this? We are trying to undo something that your all them generations before you couldn't do or didn't refuse to do. Let's be honest, they refused to do it. Right, so you out here trying to preach accountability to these women, gentlemen, it's that is falling on deaf ears. Nobody wants to hear it, because everything you saying, you're pointing the finger at her. Remember, all these years, everybody pointed the finger at you. You. It's all your fault. This has happened. Even your boy Umar Johnson is still pointing the finger at you in 2023, saying, hey, the mass incarceration, these women couldn't find men to be with. So yeah, when she says she can't find a man, there is some history behind that, because it's all on you, gentlemen. You the one that dropped the ball. Well, I wasn't here back in the 60s, so how did I drop the ball? See what I'm saying? Everybody just wants to point the finger. It's always you gentlemen, especially in the middle class. You've always been a fallback guy. See, and men like Umar Johnson this man is giving these women the green light to keep f***ing around. It's men like Umar Johnson who's giving these women the green light to keep f***ing around. No accountability, because it all goes back to you, gentlemen. It all goes back. Well, she had to be a G.I. Joe. She had to be all that she can be, because nobody was there to help her out. So nobody, come on, man. This is what I'm saying, man. This is why people still laughing at you, gentlemen. You gentlemen still sticking around the community, gentlemen. Your community doesn't belong to you. It's done. You're done. You're obsolete. As long as she's with her government, gentlemen, she's gonna ride that till the wheels fall off. And you're just a tool. You gentlemen have been, I've been saying this over and over again. You gentlemen are just a tool. You're just a tool. You're just some type of punching bag. She's going to draw that sperm from you. She's going to draw them funds from you, gentlemen. That's all it is, gentlemen. Once again, gentlemen, you are in a fucked up situation. Only thing you can do is remove yourself. Matter of fact, go let Umar Johnson fix the community. Let your man Umar Johnson fix the community. Let him fix it. See what I'm saying? The once again, the finger gets point. Once again, gentlemen, this has been going on for how long? How many decades have we been going through this? Everything is put on you, gentlemen. Now, granted, yes, there are things that we've fallen short, gentlemen. We can't sit there and be like, you know, we're not innocent of everything, gentlemen. We've all f***ed up in the community. So yes, we do have a part to play, but gentlemen, the thing is, as you can see in the numbers today, you know, we picked up our part. We've done our part. You know, if you can go on the CDC and see how many men are active in their children's lives today. Once again, we are the most active men with our children in the United States. Give us a hand. Go look these numbers up. Go look these numbers up in the CDC. We are the most active fathers in the United States compared to all these other groups of men that's out here. We are there. So all this, we ain't there. Once again, that's a motherfucking lie. We are the most active, according to the CDC, the so-called white people's numbers. Right? That pro-blackity black stuff. According to the white people's numbers, we are the most active in our children's lives. So you men ain't there, you men ain't this, you men ain't that. Once again, that's a complete fucking lie. And the CDC backs that up. So once again, never heard an apology. You know what, gentlemen, you right. There's no apology, and there's never going to be an apology as long as men like Umar Johnson is still in your so-called community preaching this it's all your fault, black man nonsense. These women ain't never gonna apologize to you younger generations. These women ain't never apologize to your fathers. These women ain't never apologize to your grandfathers and your great-greats. Nobody has ever heard an apology from these women at all for the part they play in the debauchery called the American black community. There's never been an apology, and guess what? There's never going to be one. It is what it is. It is what it is. There's no point of keep arguing with people, gentlemen. It is what it is. No accountability. Without accountability, gentlemen, you don't have a community. There's failures going on every single day, gentlemen. You see the failures going on in the so-called American black community every single day. We can't sit here and act like it's not f-ing happening. And when somebody does point it out, it goes right back to you, man. Well, if you men would have did your thing back 60 years ago, these women wouldn't be in this predicament now. And this is why, gentlemen, it's this your community, it's a sinking ship, man. It's sinking really fast. This is why there's so much kickback and there's so much attitude about you passport bros leaving and doing this, that, and the third. Now you gentlemen are supposed to go down with the ship also. No siree. You brothers are like, man, listen, I'm not going down with the ship. I'm not going down with the ship. If the community, if this is what these women want to do, no accountability. You know, because listen, gentlemen, accountability is something foreign to these women. I'm telling you, Your father didn't talk about no accountability. If they did, it was very little. Your grandfather sure enough didn't talk about no accountability. Your great-grandfather didn't talk about no accountability. But you gentlemen, especially in 2023, you gentlemen are listen, that accountability thing is ringing loud and clear. They got to get your man Umar Johnson to get his cape and to come shield these women from this accountability nonsense. I mean, accountability, not nonsense. They got to get your boy Umar Johnson to get his cape on, be a cape crusader for these females. And how dare you tell these women to be accountable when it's your fault to begin with? Well, once again, I'm born in 81. I wasn't there in the 70s. I wasn't there in the 60s. So how am I being blamed for something I wasn't even there for? Can I get an A? Freaking man. Oh, sorry about that. How are the younger generations being blamed for something they weren't even there for? See what I'm saying? I'm being blamed for something I wasn't there for. If I'm there and I created the mess, then of course, it's my responsibility to clean it up. But if I wasn't there, if I'm born in 81, you're talking about mass incarcerations back in the 70s. In 67, Cushing versus Virginia, I mean, I'm born 14 years later. So how am I going to say, oh, this falls back on, especially the millennial generation. Hell, and the brothers born in the 70s. How are we going to take responsibility for something we didn't even create? We weren't there for it. We're just a byproduct of, you know, we're coming on the tail end of it. And now all of a sudden people are taking offense to you gentlemen in 2023 talking about these women need to be more accountable. How I mean, see gentlemen, it's not looking good for you because these women have taken a stance basically against you. And they got your man Umar Johnson out here with Mr. K Crusader himself trying to save these women. Trying to shield these women from all your toxic masculinity. Dr. Umar is gonna shield Keisha and them from your toxic masculinity because you're telling Keisha in 2023 you need to be accountable. See, it's laughable, gentlemen. All this is laughable. So once again, you gentlemen talk about accountability that makes you the bad guy. So you gentlemen in 2023 talking about being accountable so we can make a change, so we can fix our mistakes and move forward. That makes you toxic. And once again, And all of a sudden, and the thing is, you gentlemen see, we all see the same thing. We see it, and you brothers, you say, you know what? F*** it. Let's get our passports. SYSBN, we're going to save ourselves. We're going to create new communities elsewhere. But once again, gentlemen, you wrong. You wrong again. So you gentlemen were wrong. Because you weren't there back in the 60s and 70s, right? So you gentlemen were wrong. Because, you know, these women didn't have, you weren't there. You gentlemen, you know, you weren't there. Well, I was born in 81, so I don't know. I don't know how I'm getting blamed for that, but okay, cool. So you weren't there. Well, here's the thing. For the men that were there, like what was happening? It was just mass incarceration. Okay, cool. So there was mass incarceration. So all these brothers were getting arrested. Well, okay, cool. If we talk about nation building and you got women out here with no men, this is when you introduce polygamy or polygyny. Right? We can't use excuses. Once again, if there's all these women out here with no man, all these men getting arrested, so why wasn't polygyny introduce? It's just common. Come on, man. It's just common sense. If there's a mass shortage of men. Why didn't these women just, hey, listen, the brothers that are all around, that's all around doing the thing. Why wasn't polygyny? Let's be honest. I'm being dead serious. You know, I'm being dead serious. Why wasn't polygyny being introduced? Like, that's a perfect time to introduce some type of polygyny. Listen, sisters, you know, there's not enough men out here. Because once again, any smart society does this. You guys, are you pro-blacks? Keep talking about Africa this, Africa that. Well, this is what countries in Africa are doing. Listen, since there is a shortage, a small amount of men in some of these countries, some of these governments are saying, yeah, well, you listen, some of you brothers, you're going to need to take on a couple wives. This is happening in Africa right now. You guys, all this pro-blackity black stuff. Okay, cool. There's countries in Africa right now. You guys can go Google it. There are countries in Africa right now telling these men, listen, there's a shortage amount of men. Listen, matter of fact, they made a law. I can't think of the country. There's a few countries out there that made it law that you men have to mandatory at least marry 2 to 3 wives. This is mandatory in these countries. Why wasn't that put into the place in the black community? Oh, because it's illegal. Okay, listen, man. Okay. So, baby mama culture is better than being in the polygynous culture. Baby mama culture is better than the polygynous culture. You females connecting to one man, having a husband there, at least you got a protector. You guys could have moved out to the countryside. Hell, if you guys are sitting up in the cities, maybe you need to move out to Utah. Because Utah is legal to be in a plural relationship. Once again, no accountability for nothing. Just want to point the blame so we can keep the debauchery going on in the so-called community. Just keep the debauchery going. Just keep it going. Bunch of kids running around with no daddies. It doesn't matter. Long as one of them kids, long as Michael Jordan can come out one of them kids. As long as LeBron James can come out one of these kids. Odell Beckham can come out one of these kids. Shaquille O'Neal can come out one of these kids. It doesn't matter. Let these black people just run wild. As long as we can get one of these Superman babies to fill up our arenas, to go to our colleges, to sing on somebody else's stage, to rap, to dance and to twerk. Once again, as long as we can keep them dysfunctional, once again, it doesn't matter. They don't have to be accountable. No, these women don't have to be accountable. Nobody has to be accountable in the black community. It is what it is. It's just a free-for-all. Everybody's just doing everything. Anything is everything. Everything's anything. It doesn't matter. As long as when your kids are 7 feet tall and can dunk a basketball, then it's all to the good. As long as one of your babies can be a Beyonce. One of your babies could be a Jay-Z one day. One of your babies could be a Whitney Houston. Huh? One of your babies can be a playing a Major League Baseball. One of your babies can be another Michael B. Jordan. A Jonathan Majors. A Denzel Washington. As long as one of your babies can make us money, then hey, you know, whatever. Let the debauchery keep going. No accountability. So yeah, gentlemen, if without accountability, there is no community, man. Let's stop playing the game. Without accountability, I don't care what Umar Johnson got to say. Without accountability, gentlemen, you don't have no community. You just playing yourself. And every time you walk outside, everybody behind closed doors. Look at Gerard. Like your name. Look at Jason. Look at Rashid. Everybody laughing at you, bro. Everybody laughing at you. Everybody's laughing at you. You gentlemen still sitting up there and you pleading and begging and pleading, and you know you out here doing the James Brown. Please, please. You doing a Key Sweat out here, Jake? Gentlemen, you out here begging like Key Sweat? See, gentlemen, once again, this is what everybody's doing. They laughing at you. You don't have a community, gentlemen. You don't have anything. You can create anything you want to, but gentlemen, as far as this community and the female you keep talking about, she this is my sister, gentlemen. She's not f***ing with you. There's no accountability. Once again, think about it, gentlemen. How are you going to establish a community if you can't be in union with these females? These females have gotten the green light to do whatever the f*** they want to do. These women in your community have gotten the green light to be, once again, they claim they're independent. I already told you what the first word of independent means, free. So these women are free from you. So if somebody's claiming to be independent, which is free, of course they're not going to have accountability, gentlemen. If somebody's claiming to be independent, which is free from you, these women can think on their own. They can do this on their own. They can do whatever on their own. They're free from you. They're free from your say-so. They're free. They've also been integrated into this burning building, which is the whole United States. It's Martin Luther King said, I fear that I have integrated my people into a burning building. And the burning building is the United States, and it's burning. So, gentlemen, there's not going to be accountability. I don't understand. You don't have a community if you don't have accountability. Because there's not going to be any recognition of failures. And without the recognition of failures, there's not going to be any growth, gentlemen. This is where you are right now. Begging and pleading, come back together, gentlemen. There is no negotiation table. I told you, these women are not f***ing with you. These women are not f***ing with you. They got the backing of the Big Daddy government. They got the backing of him. Keep producing these bastard kids. We need another Shaquille O'Neal. Shaquille O'Neal's getting old. We need another one. We need more football players. We need more baseball players. We need more hockey. We need more rap. We need more twerking. So of course the United States is not going to tell Keisha now to be accountable. No. Because when you guys were, when the family unit was together, gentlemen, there was order and there was structure. There was order and there was structure. But they know if they offered this woman a way out back in the 60s, she was going to take it. And she did. It is what it is. Not pointing the finger. It is what it is. These women took your so-called United States government offered these women a way out back in the 60s. And still to this day, they have chosen their government to this day. I'm not blaming anybody. That's just what it is, gentlemen. That's life. There's not going to be any apologies. The thing is, these women have stood fast on their decision. These women have stood fast on their decision, gentlemen. There's not going to be an apology. There's not going to be an accountability. And basically, there really is no community. Still to this day, these women have stood fast with their government like they did back in the 60s. It is what it is, gentlemen. I don't understand why you gentlemen are not getting this concept. why aren't you gentlemen getting this concept? Seriously, why aren't you gentlemen? Why isn't this not clicking in your head? These women have stood fast. They have locked hand in hand, arm in arm with the American government ever since the 60s, gentlemen. These women have not changed their mind in 50 some odd years. So you think these women are going to drop everything their grandma, that their grandma, great grandmama, and great great grandmama did? You think they're going to drop 50 some years of this decision? You think they're going to drop that for you? They're not going to do that. You think these women are going to, listen, 50 some odd years, these women, this is what these women have built in 50 plus years. Damn near 60 years. He was talking about slavery. I ain't talking about no slavery. I'm talking about since the 60s. Hell, you talk 1960 to 2023, to my 63 years. I'm saying since 67. No, that's like 56. So yeah, gentlemen, I don't understand. Like, these women have no incentive of being accountable. They have a backup plan for everything that they do. Gentlemen, there's a backup plan to everything that these women do. There's a backup plan. You, my friend, are the backup plan to everything she does. This is why these women are getting mad that her backup plan is leaving and going to other countries. You gentlemen don't get it?
Oh no!
Seriously, gentlemen, you don't get it? These women are mad at you. This is why the video talk about knowing your worth, gentlemen. These women are mad at you because her backup plan is leaving. You, gentlemen, especially in the middle class, you're the backup plan. You're the backup plan. You're supposed to be here just like your daddy was here, just like your granddaddy was here, just like your great granddaddy was here. You're supposed to be the backup plan. Forever, forever, ever, forever, ever. Yeah. You're supposed to be the backup plan. So listen. The accountability. Why are you leaving? Why is my backup plan leaving? Like, you guys seen the movie The Island, and when that man Matt Damon, I guess when his clone got into the car, he called his doctor, was like, hey man, why is my insurance plan in the car? Same thing with you, gentlemen. This is why these women are looking at everybody. These women in the community are looking at everybody, looking at the government. You're looking at the government like, United States, why is the backup plan leaving? Which goes back to the worth. You guys, you gentlemen know your worth. So guess what? You are leaving. It's just that simple. If I know my worth, I'm not being appreciated where I'm at. I'm only thing that's happening where I'm at right now, I'm being tolerated. I'm not being appreciated. Nobody wants to listen to me. Nobody wants to follow the things that I'm saying. Everything is a free for all. Everything is a freaking jungle gym. Anything and everything can happen. Guess what, gentlemen? You get up out of here. You don't have to ask questions. I don't have to ask the so-called community, these women in the community, can I leave? No, man. No, gentlemen, you just getting the f*** out of here. You gentlemen are just getting the f*** out of here. There's no point of asking questions. Can I leave? Do you gentlemen need a permission slip to leave? You gentlemen need a permission slip from your mommy? I'm 41 years old. I need to ask my mommy to sign a permission slip so I can go out to the different countries so I can find my helpmate, the one that I want, the one that I desire, the one that I need. I need to have a permission slip. I need to talk to Keisha around the corner over here and get a permission slip for her to sign off on me to go to a different part of the country. To go to South America, Africa, wherever I want to go, I need permission slip from these women to community so I can make that exit. But you women can go out to Africa and go to Jamaica and go wherever you want to go. Nobody says nothing. But when a brother, when a so-called you middle class men go out here and you do the same thing they do, you're exercising the same thing they're exercising, all of a sudden it's a problem. But somehow, come on, gentlemen, man. Come on, man. I'm gonna say it again. Without accountability, gentlemen, there is no community. These women have been given the incentive not to be accountable, especially to you. Only person that these females in the community is gonna be accountable is to Big Daddy government. That's it. It is what it is, gentlemen. That's the hand you were dealt with. Remember, I was born in 81. All this stuff took place 10 years prior to me coming into this world. So, gentlemen, if you were born in the 70s, gentlemen, you might have been a child when all this stuff was taking place. So, once again, how are we responsible for what's happening today? How are we the younger ones responsible for what's happening today? Only ones that I'm responsible is for my two little girls back up in Maryland. I'm only responsible for those two. I'm not responsible for everybody running around here. This ain't the good old days. This ain't the 50s. You know, hey, listen, if everything, once again, being, being independent, one of the bywords of being independent, I told you guys, was individualistic. So you're in an independent, these women are in the community, are independent. So everybody in this community is an individual. You can't claim to have a community and be individualistic. Doesn't make sense. You can't claim to be independent in the same sentence claim there's some type of community. No, the byword of independent is individualistic. So if these women in this quote unquote, whatever it is, the box, I don't know, community, whatever you want to call it, is individualistic, gentlemen, it doesn't make sense. The more and more you even talk about this, it just sounds dumb. It just sounds dumb. You're independent, but there's a community. So there's a community of independent women. So there's a community of individualistic women. See, gentlemen, the more and more you just talk about this stuff, the more dumb it just is. Gives you more more ammunition to roll out. Nobody's listening to Dr. Umar Johnson. If you didn't create the mess, which is the so-called American Black community to this day, because this has been going on for the last damn near 60 years. Gentlemen, then it's not for you to clean it up. Whatever children that you have, that's your responsibility, gentlemen. My children are my responsibility, not person over here, not this family over here, not this family over here. Now, if somebody asks me for help, that's one thing, but I'm not gonna go, I'm not gonna go and just, hey, you're my responsibility. Nah. Gentlemen, don't be used like a tool. Don't get little boy. Right, how do you say? I would say in New York, don't get sunned out here. S-O-N. Don't get sunned out here, gentlemen, because that's what's happening. Somebody's trying to sun you into being here and to being some type of cleanup guy, into being some type of janitor. So these females can do whatever they want to do. There's no accountability on any. Nobody's telling her she needs to do X, Y, and Z. Nobody, not even your American government, is not telling her. Because once again, there's a backup plan to everything she does. Oops, you get pregnant, there's a backup plan for that. Oops, you falling short on money, there's a backup plan for that. Oops, you had nowhere to stay, there's a backup plan for that. Oops, you need subsidies to get food and all that stuff, there's a backup plan for that. So there's no need for these women to be accountable, especially to you, especially if she's claiming to be independent. She's not going to be accountable to you, gentlemen. So since there's no accountability on her part, then gentlemen, there is no community. Seriously. You gentlemen, like I said videos before, gentlemen, you're going to have to separate. It's that time. My last video, you gentlemen are just going to have to separate. It is what it is, gentlemen. It's coming down to the bottom line. It's up to you, gentlemen. What are you going to do? You going to stay with the sinking ship? Or are you going to go your separate way? That's the only two choices that you have, gentlemen. You're going to stay with the sinking ship and be with Umar and all them, whatever. Because I guarantee you, when Boo Boo really hits the fan, oh, he's going to try to get up out of there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, when Boo Boo really hits the fan. Like I said, in 10 years, 10, 20 years, yeah. Your community will be in a police state because, yeah, this violence is getting crazy with these children coming from these single mothers. Yeah, I'm going to be honest. In 10, 20 years, yeah, your community is going to be in a police state. It is what it is. And when that happens, you think Umar are going to be up there talking about some Pan-African and this, that, and the third, and we can't do this. Let's fight and just do. Nah, man, your man is about to get the f*** up out of there. He's about to bounce, and everybody that's like him, all that Pan-African stuff, all them pro-blacks are getting up out of here. They gonna lead these women to their devices. So yeah, gentlemen, once again, without accountability, there is no community. Because your community is not gonna grow. There's a bunch of failures. Like I said, with failure comes recognition, which leads to growth. If there is no even acknowledgement of failure in the community, there's definitely not going to be any type of recognition that's going to cause some changes, and there's not going to be any growth happening. If you can't even recognize the failures that's going on, gentlemen, how you expect this so-called community to grow? There is no recognition of failures. We see the failures going on all day, every day. We can turn on the news and see failures within the so-called community happen every single day. But it is, it's not really happening like that. But you put the mirror up and you say, yeah, it is happening like that. Well, you listen to this bozo, Dr. Umar. Well, if you gentlemen would have stepped your game up back in the 60s, back in the 70s, this wouldn't have happened. Deuces. A shout out to the dramatic. How to put it, dramatics, gentlemen. What you see is what you get, gentlemen. This is exactly what's happening. That's why I played the song. What you see is what you get. Gentlemen, there is no accountability, so there is no community. What you see is what you get. And this is what you're getting, gentlemen. So, gentlemen, do your thing, man. I don't know, man. Give yourself a hand, man. Gentlemen, you got it. You got it, man. You got it. Hey, I appreciate everybody once again coming by. I just had to say my two-piece. I know that clip was played. That was aired maybe a couple weeks ago. I just had to say my two-piece about it. But yeah, gentlemen, it just came to my mind. Without accountability, gentlemen, there is no community. Anyways, man, hey, if you guys can come by my website, show some love for my merchandise. www.1247clothingcompany.org. Please come by, show me some love. Once again, it goes my, hold up a second. Did I complain the whole thing? Once again, if you guys see on the bottom there, if you guys can donate to my Cash App, to my PayPal, I greatly appreciate it. Once again, this is not a bashing.
What?
My bad. This is not a bashing session. Gentlemen, you just got to. Listen, rubber has to meet the road, gentlemen. You have to put the ball. If you gentlemen call yourself kings, gentlemen, you got to make some king's decisions, like right about now. You can't wait 10 years. You got to make your decision right about now, gentlemen, because it is what it is. These women have spoken. They are locked hand in hand with the government ever since the 60s, gentlemen. There's nothing you can do. You can't undo that. Your degrees ain't going to cut it. Your swag ain't going to cut it. Your Rolex watches ain't gonna cut it. Your bling bling is not gonna cut it. These women are hand in hand locked in with the government. She's never letting that go. She's never gonna let the government go. It is what it is, gentlemen. Only thing you can do is save yourself. Only thing you can do is get a passport. Only thing you can do is go your own way. Gentlemen, that's the only choices that you really have. And separate and create something new somewhere else, gentlemen, because whatever this is, it's a wrap. But once again, gentlemen, I'm gonna stop having these conversations. You gentlemen got it, man. Hey, gentlemen, hey, whatever it is that you gentlemen are gonna do, do it. Just stay out of my face. Because you gentlemen see me walking around with something other than Keisha. Yeah, please stay out of my face. And please don't point fingers. Please don't laugh. Don't say nothing. Keep doing what you've been doing. And yeah, that's all I got to say. But anyways, man, that's my time. You tell me to stay up and make a good decision. Because it's not looking good for you right now. I'm out. Peace.